Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Gaming on Caffeine. My name is Isaac, and we are back for episode 5 of Prison Architect. It is day 12 here in our prison. It's almost 5 a.m., and in just over 3 hours, we are going to accept 4 new prisoners into our prison, 2 of which are going to go into our brand new minimum security wing that we set up down here at the end of last episode. And I'm hoping that after we receive these 4 prisoners, that the number of minimum security prisoners available goes up, because right now there are only 2 available, which means no matter how many cells we have, we can only take in 2 minimum security prisoners tomorrow. And so I'm hoping that after we take those 2 in, that another like 10 or 20 or 30 preferably will become available for us to take in tomorrow and start to fill up this new little wing that we set up down here. Now, whilst we wait for that to happen, there are a couple of security flaws and a couple of things wrong with the prison that I found since the end of last episode. The first of which I found whilst I was looking at the intelligence tab, because if we look at all of the contraband that was in our prison over the last 7 days that we found on prisoners whilst we're doing like shakedowns and individual searches, we can see that a lot of it was smuggled in via this little corridor that we have like unintentionally created here as a way into the prison. And you can see all these people using it. We have a bunch of guards, a bunch of janitors, and all of these workers who are using this as the default way into the prison. And the reason why they're doing that is because it's easier than going through the jail doors. They don't have to wait for somebody to open the door for them. But the reason why that's a problem is that when they go through here, they bring stuff into the prison that doesn't go past any jail doors, any guards, any guard dogs, or any metal detectors. There is literally no security whatsoever on this corridor. And so all of the stuff, all of the contraband, or at least a lot of the contraband that's being brought in, is being brought in through this tunnel here, because it's so easy to get stuff in without it being detected. And that wasn't the intention of these 2 staff doors. This one is to allow all of the people who work in the office block to get into the office building. And then this one over here, and this one was built to allow workmen to get out into the like area between the buildings and lay down pipe, maybe some electrical cable, or put down things like these water heaters. And so the first thing that we are going to do in today's episode is I'm going to go ahead and grab some perimeter fence, and I'm going to stick them down there, there, and then here. We don't really need this one, because this one is also going to be blocked by this one, but this one down here definitely has the same problem. People can just walk straight through here and then into there. It's a little bit harder to do because they do have to walk through this staff door or this staff door and then go around and then walk up here and then through this staff door, so it becomes a bit more of an issue. But I do not want any other way into my prison that is not through this front door here. And when I found that, I also then realized that we have almost no security by our front door either, because although we have guards and although we have the jail doors, there are no metal detectors between all of the stuff coming in and our prisoners. All of the metal detectors that we have are either on the canteen. We've got 3 here, and we didn't even finish this one over here, so let me quickly throw one down right about there. Or we have one down here on the visitation room, which, while that's going to stop people bringing stuff in and out of visitation, it's not going to stop people taking stuff out of, like, the food boxes or smuggling things in inside of the storage crates. And so instead, what we're going to do is we're going to dismantle this one here, and I'm going to put it back down right there where that light bulb is, so that all of the stuff that comes into and out of the prison has to go through that metal detector before they can get to the prisoners. Even the people going to the visitation room will have to pass through here before they can get in. And hopefully, that's going to reduce the amount of contraband in our prison, which should overall reduce the number of issues that we have with our prisoners. So that's the one problem that I found with security. The other problem that I found is if we go to logistics and we look at the food distribution, right now, oh, this is actually fine. Earlier when I looked, it said demand 51 and supply was like 10. And so I thought that we were drastically understaffed for the amount of food that we needed. But it looks like between the hours of 5 a.m. and 7 a.m., they have managed to cook enough food to feed all of our prisoners. So hopefully everyone should be fine now. It's just ticked over to 7 a.m. I'm going to speed the game up a little bit here. Everyone's going out for their morning shower. I did want to do a shakedown in the middle of the night just there, but a couple of people in the comments section told me that shakedowns are not necessarily the most effective way of trying to find tunnels, because when you instigate a shakedown, when you start the shakedown, all of the prisoners will start to try and hide their stuff, making it a lot harder to find things like tunnels when the prisoners already know that a shakedown is in progress. And so what we're going to do instead is, whilst everybody is in the shower, getting clean. Everyone apart from these guys, that is, because these guys are just sat in their normal cells taking a shower. But whilst most of the prisoners are in the shower and about to be on their way to the canteen, we're going to do a cell block search. So right now, we're going to like click on one of these guys, and we're just going to search the entire cell block. So we're not going to search the whole building. Shakedown will involve like searching all of the storage boxes, all the stuff in the kitchen. It searches everywhere. This time, we are just going to search everybody in every room within this prison cell block to see if anybody has any contraband and to see if anyone is trying to break out. We've already found some prescription drugs and we already found some alcohol. I'm hoping we don't find any tunnels, but if there are any tunnels, I do hope we find them. This seems to be working fine. Everyone's kind of still being searched. It's a bit of a pain. What is everyone's needs like right now? I don't think people are going to be too happy about that. Actually, for the most part, everyone seems to be fine. Like, it's a little bit with exercise, a little bit with family. Once yard time rolls around, they should start using the phone booth, and that family should go down, recreation should go down, and exercise should go down as well. And so what I want to work on in today's episode is I want to work on building an expansion to our prison down here. I'm going to build, like, a big building. If we go into planning mode, I want it to look something like this. It's going to be a big old building, and this is going to contain, at the very least, our new parole rooms. Because, like I said last episode, one of the main reasons for building a big minimum security wing is that the minimum security guys are very easy to get in and out on parole. You can let them go very quickly, and so you can actually make quite a bit of money from just cycling through a lot of minimum security prisoners. And so what I think we're going to end up doing, I also kind of want to make this into two separate buildings like that, so we can separate the minimum security from the normal security guys. And so what I want to do is make sure we have a bunch of parole rooms down here so they can go through as many prisoners as possible and try and get as many out as possible. And I also want to expand out the minimum security wing up here as well. I want to build out like here because we are very close to being able to complete the cell block C grant. We've got 74 capacity right now. If we can increase our prisoner capacity to 100, that will automatically complete the cell block C grant, which will get us an extra $30,000. And so I do want to do that. I also want to get the parole rooms up and running. But right now we've only got $9,000. And so in order to get a bit more money, we're going to start with the MaxSec infrastructure implementation grant, which wants us to increase the size of the security force, which is a bit of a vague objective. I'm not quite sure what that means, but I'm assuming it just means have more guards, have more guard dogs, and have a couple of armed guards around. We also have to unlock body armor through bureaucracy, unlock tasers, build a CCTV monitor, and then place CCTV cameras throughout your prison. Whoa, we got a call from the warden. What's going on? A power surge has caused our generator to overload and catch fire. Okay. Now, this could have been really bad, like really, really bad, if we didn't put a sprinkler in this room just last episode, because I've seen this before. These are like the little events. When you tick the events box, when you start a prison, this is the kind of thing that you're getting yourself in for. If we didn't have a sprinkler in there, which is like right there, if we didn't have that sprinkler in, that fire could have spread very, very quickly and very easily destroyed a big section of our prison. So I'm super happy that we got our sprinklers down when we did. Thankfully, that should all be fine now. And actually, everything's back up and running. Within like 20 minutes, everything went back up very, very quickly. Yard time isn't even over yet. So most of the prisoners won't have even noticed that happened. But I'm so glad we put out that sprinkler. Jeez, that was just in time. Also, we are very high up on power usage right now. Let's go ahead and throw down a couple more of these capacitors just along the bottom here like that. Let's get back to that grant. So we've done most of the stuff already. We've already got CCTV, and we've already got the CCTV monitor. The things that we don't have are unlock tasers and body armor through bureaucracy. So both of these take $1,000 and 6 hours to complete. So we'll do both of those. We can't unlock two at the same time. I can't queue those up. Oh, we don't have the money. We've only got $384. Wow. Okay. Yeah, we just spent quite a bit on capacitors, didn't we? Wow. Okay. So we're really low on money right now. But I think for the most part, our prison is actually running fairly well. Not all the needs are being met. No one is really complaining too much about anything. They're complaining a little bit about recreation. But if we go to our regime, they are in for some free time after their second shower of the day. Oh, last episode, we had an issue, didn't we? We got rid of, we had like lockdown. And then we put in a second shower just so that people didn't complain. We don't need that anymore. We can put that as free time. And so the recreation should go away pretty quickly there. And we should probably actually get a guard patrolling down here in minimum security, because we do have a few people down here now, and we currently cannot see a flipping thing. So you know what? Let's have a guy patrol there, and I'm also thinking that I might want to have, like, a CCTV camera here, here, and here, kind of just at the end of the corridor, so we can see what's going in all of the cells, even when the guard's not there, because you'll see, the guard's going to move away pretty quick, and once he gets over here, we're probably going to lose sight of what's going on in this cell block. Possibly. Although it looks like this guy's got a pretty good idea of what's going on throughout this cell block now, so we might not have to put down any kind of CCTV cameras. I'll keep an eye on it, and if we see any dark spots appearing down here in the minimum security wing, we can always throw down some CCTV later. We should go and accept those grants. So let's grab this one, and then let's grab this one. The MaxSec infrastructure implementation gives us 20,000 both before and after. So that gives us a ton of money, and in 12 hours, once both of these are done, that should be pretty much good to go. What are we missing now? Yeah, we just need to unlock both of these, and then the grant is complete, and we will get a further 20,000. So, let's start looking into expanding down here a little bit. If we go to planning, so we're gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4. We're gonna have a few more cells along here. We're gonna try and increase the capacity of our prison to 100. So, we're gonna have a pathway that's too wide there, and then, of course, on this side, we're gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4. So, door, toilet, bed, and then wall. So I might bring this back a little bit to, like, there. But we'll see how big it is. If we've got enough cells with, like, this space, then I will leave it like this. If we're just, like, a few cells short, I might push it again. Also, we can probably change this double cell here into a single cell. And then if we do something like this... Oh, look at that. It fits perfectly. It fits perfectly. Oh, I love it. Okay, so how many cells is that going to get us? Right now, we're at 74. That's going to be 75, 6, 7, 8, 9... 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, that takes us like 98 cells. Ah, okay, so you know what? You know what? We're replacing these. These are no longer going to be solitary cells. These are instead just going to be normal, standard cells like all the rest of them. And that should take us up to 100 capacity, which gives us another 20,000 for completing that cell block C grant, at which point we are going to have just a ton of money. So, let's go ahead and build that there. That's 3,880. And let's also go ahead and build, you know, we'll build it here first. We'll start with normal security because right now we've got 2 minimum security prisoners and only 12 more arriving tomorrow. So, even though we've got space for like 40 minimum security prisoners, we do kind of need to focus on the normal security guys for now. And so we'll set this up down here and we'll use this as the parole room or the space for the parole room and probably other stuff as well for medium security. And we also need to have there a little way for them to connect and get in. So that's be like the pathway that just continues on down. That should all be good. We'll speed things up a little bit because it is going to take our guys a little bit of time to get here. And speaking of speed, I was looking at the materials tab over here, which is a tab that I usually use just for making walls, but there are a bunch of different floors that we can make, and for the most part, I thought these were mostly just cosmetic, but after doing a little bit of research, when you hover over these, it says walking speed, and then, for example, paving stones have a walking speed that is fast, compared to, like, sand, which has a walking speed of slow, and certain things like wooden floors, which have a walking speed of normal. And so I went to the wiki, and I was like, what is this about? And it turns out that certain tiles make your people walk faster. This is especially useful for example, your workmen, because by default, this dirt has a walking speed of normal, and so if I was to replace this, oh my goodness, what's happening? Someone's been attacked. What's going on? What's going on? He's unconscious. Oh, he's a gang member. Also, actually, we'll come back to the paved stones in a second. One thing that I did find out between episodes, let me quickly bulldoze these walls here and here, is that under intelligence, we actually have a gang section, so we can see who is in a gang. Right now, there are 3 gangs, red, green, and blue. I don't know if any more gangs arise later on throughout the game, but we've got 9 members in the red gang who have a total of $14.46. Like, they're a pretty wealthy gang, all things considered. And I'm assuming this guy, Fletcher, is the leader of the gang because he's got, like, this massive red circle around him. And then I'm not quite sure what the red rooms mean. Are these, like, meeting spots where the gang will actually meet? I'm not quite sure, but we can see all the people who are in the gang. It's fairly obvious who's in the gang because they've got, like, the similar, like, face tattoos on them. But I was fairly interested in that. Also, has this guy broken his toilet? 83% damaged. What the heck? Was it this guy? Yeah, it was. Under misconduct, we've got attacked staff and destruction. You know what? You flippin' show map sheet. Maximum security. Boom. Also, Fletcher, this guy right here. Boom. Just for being a gang leader. Maximum security. Boom. All right. I do want to set up a maximum security wing at some point as well. If not just to get the maximum security guys away from the minimum security guys, I think that having all of those gang members close together, especially having the gang leader close to all the rest of the gang members, is not going to be a good thing in the long run. And so I would like to set up a maximum security area at some point, probably like up here. Out of the way, like away from everything else. Also, we need to bulldoze some walls down here to make room for this new little section that we've set up. Demolish walls, boom, and boom. And then once that's done, we can start putting cells down. We can start copy and pasting that. That's going to be pretty expensive, but overall should be fine. And we also need to start unlocking tasers so we can get that next $20,000. So let's have a look down here. If we type in parole, is there any requirement for how big a parole room has to be? Yes, it has to be at least 5 by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's really annoying, because it can go there, but it can't go there because we have to have a wall there. So it can't go there, which is really annoying. And I'm assuming this is too big, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's 7. So you know what? 7 by 5, that's going to be 1. And then a wall, and then like 7 by 6 is going to be another one there. And then you know what? We'll have... Actually, can we make this... Can we do 5 by 5... 5 by 5. How many can we fit in over here? This is quite a lot of them. We don't probably need quite this many. Can we fit in one there? Oh, we can't. That's real, real annoying. But you know what? We'll have 3 there. We'll have like a pathway there, just in front of the parole rooms, going all the way along to the end like that. And then I'm not quite sure what we're going to put here. We'll figure out something. We'll put something else here at some point in the future. Of course, we're going to have like probably a wall there, a wall there, a wall there. Get rid of that and that and that. It's probably going to end up looking something like this. I might put down a second cleaning cupboard at some point, because right now we've only got space for 3 people to work. And the more cleaning cupboards we put down, or the bigger we make cleaning cupboards, the more people we can have working in the cleaning industry. And the cleaner we can try and make the prison. I also actually might put some solitary cells down here. Like I might... I do something like this. If I get the wall tool real quick, I might just put like a bunch of solitary cells along here. This is like a really annoyingly wide room, but I might end up putting in some like solitary cells down here. I'm not quite sure. We'll figure that out later on, but for now I want to make sure that we go to walls, concrete, get a big old wall. Is that right there, or is that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? No, that wants to be a wall like that. And so this planning does not want to look like this. It wants to be one further out. So the pathway wants to be there, and then the walls are going to be here, which works a little nicer, because then we can have like solitary here and here, and then we can have solitary all along here as well, like that, that, and that. And then we can do the exact same thing over here on this side. We can boom and have some extra solitary. You know what? I'm going to do that as well, because we've always got people waiting to go into solitary. Like right now, we've got 2 people who are waiting to go into solitary, and we never have enough solitary cells for any of that. And so we will also do something like this. Put all these in, and these are all going to become solitary cells. Cool. All right. We also need walls here and here and here. And then we need to put some doors on there. I think we can just go with normal doors. Like, there's nothing that's kept in the parole rooms that is particularly dangerous, so it doesn't really matter too much if prisoners have access to it. Also, I press play and it's on full speed. Oh, these guys are all trapped in. I wondered why they weren't doing anything. Flipping egg. All right, solitary door. Let's do this, this, and... Oh, what's... Oh, we've just, like, left a little bit of a hole there, haven't we? From where the buildings don't connect. And then we'll go boom, 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 and boom. They were actually really expensive solitary doors. Flipping heck. All right. It's fine, though. It's fine. We'll connect up this again, make it look nice. This is now ready, so we can go back to walls here and start building in some of these concrete walls like this. Don't want it there. I just want it along like this. And then once that's done, we can grab our clone tool, start cloning all of these up, and that should increase our cell capacity, our prisoner capacity, up to 100. Also, we want to bulldoze that wall there, and there we go. All right. Someone also said to me that the laundry room is not currently set to minimum security only, and it is not. Actually, nothing is. Why? Why does everything suddenly unset itself? I want all of that to be normal security. I want all of this down here to be minimum, minimum. This can just be anybody. We should probably set certain areas to staff only. Like, for example, all of this wants to be staff only, obviously. I would say that this area here wants to be staff only. We should probably put a door right on the visitation room so that we can make like this area here, staff only, because I don't want any prisoners walking down this corridor without a member of staff. I want them to always be guided by a member of staff into visitation room. The staff room is, of course, going to be staff only, and this is staff only. The canteen is fine, the kitchen is fine, the kennel and the armory and the storage and the security room are all staff only. That should be fine. I don't think we're going to see anybody trying to get into, like, the security room anyway, but it's better safer than sorry. Also, should we get rid of this, right? Like, this shouldn't be, like, just a hole. Is that actually a room, or have we... Yeah, that's actually a room. Okay. It's, like, it's got a weird... Like, what is this? Why is there a black line there? Let's bulldoze that wall, and then let's grab our quick build tool. We've only got 4,000, so I guess instead we should probably build some visitor tables first. So let's put one there, and there, and there. And now, if we go through to reports and we go down to programs, I think parole is in here. Yeah, so we've got 17 people who are in the queue waiting for a parole hearing. So you know what? We will start one parole hearing. And where's it going? Right to the top here. We'll start three parole hearings. If we hit play, once they put down those tables, that should get rid of the no equipment sign. And then I think we have to go into the edit schedule section and we have to edit where these parole hearings are. But we'll do that in a second once all of these have gone away. Let's wait for all this to be done. Is that going to go away? Or are we stuck with that? Stop, 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 start, start, start. No room found? Oh, they're right here. They're right here. Oh, that's workshop. I don't want workshop. Get rid of this. Get rid of that. I want parole. Start. There we go. Okay, start, start, and start. And so now, at 6 till 10 a.m. every single day, we should have three parole hearings going on. If we go to schedule, yeah, we can see parole, parole, and parole. It's all shared. We can, if we want to later on down the line, make it not shared, and we probably will do that once we get parole set up over here, because we don't want the minimum security guys going and trying to get their parole hearing in this room, because then they got to walk through the medium security guys and people can get injured and attacked, and we don't want that. We want to make it as secure as is possible, and we might even go for a second set of them. Like, as soon as the first three are finished at 10 a.m., we're going to go straight back in and we're going to have a second round of parole hearings at 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. That might be a little bit overkill. We will find out. I'm not sure if that costs us any money. It probably does, in like administrative fees or something, but that's fine. Actually, speaking of fees, we have not changed our food policy. If we go to policy here, right now we're feeding them high quantity, high variety meals, which in total is costing us $1,710 per day. And if we just decrease these to medium, that's going to save us over $1,000 in feeding our prisoners. It does mean they're going to be a little bit less satisfied with the food, but I think for the time being, medium quality and medium variety should be just fine. Also, we did just complete the security grant. We finished up finding tasers and body armor in bureaucracy. We should also probably do taser rollout so we can start to give all of our guards tasers, give them a bit of a more effective way of taking down some of our prisoners. It's 6 a.m. There's 1 hour left until everyone wakes up. We're going to do a shakedown. I want to find the tunnel. We found one. We find one guy trying to tunnel out right about here, but I'm fairly certain more people are going to try and tunnel out, like, real quick. Whilst that is going on, let's put that concrete wall there, and then let's start cloning this so we can get the other grant complete as well. So quick build, clone, let's grab everything there, and then just boom, boom, boom. Oh, I don't want to do that. Didn't want to do that. Undo. I can undo, right? Can I undo? Object? I can't undo. I can cancel it. It's fine. It's fine. Undo, and I don't want that to be a cell either. All right, quick build. Let's try that again. Clone that. Here, 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 and here. There we go. All right. And then we'll clone you. Oh, no. Yeah, that's right. And then we'll put you along here. It just ticked over to 7 a.m., so everyone should now be going for a shower, which is fine. People are a little bit annoyed. Oh, my goodness. Oh, the gang members are fighting. See, this is where we need tasers. Oh, no. Someone's going to escape. Someone's trying to escape. Lockdown. That door's never getting opened, my friend. It's never getting opened. Oh, my goodness. Oh, this is not good. Okay. Okay. Solitary. Oh, gosh. I wonder what happened then. It's the game trying to show me where all of the solitary rooms are. Here we go. We're going to be ready. We're going to be ready for... Look at this guy's running away from the doctor who's trying to heal him. He's going... Wait, whoa, 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 whoa. He just attacked staff and he's got a parole hearing? What? That makes no sense. And also, we've got... Oh, no. We've got 12 more prisoners arriving right now. Guys, bang up. Everyone get back to your cells. Everybody get back to your cells. Flippin' egg. This guy's punching still. I don't wanna release the lock. You know what? I'm gonna lock this door shut. I'm gonna lock that door shut, but I'm gonna get rid of lockdown. So people can get around the prison, but they can't get through this door. Because I wanna make sure all these prisoners, okay, they're unconscious. Let's open the door and not lock it shut. Flippin' egg. Oh my goodness, that was not a good start to the day. Danger is pretty high. What is everybody's problem? What did I do? Is it the food? It can't be the warmth. Ah, yeah, we should. If we go to information or logistics and then temperature, the majority of the prison is pretty cold. We should definitely invest in some radiators. Our cells are currently being built, which is good. All the new minimum security guys are arriving. They've just arrived, and so they're going to be taken and put into their stuff. They're not going to be greeted by the nicest of sights. We've got all these people who just tried to escape and tried to destroy other staff members and human beings, but you know what? That's fine. That's fine. We should change our prison policy when it comes to misconduct. Because right now, an escape attempt is just 2 hours of lockdown. I feel like an escape attempt is like at least 10 hours in solitary confinement. If you attack a prisoner, I'm going to give you solitary as well for like 3 hours. If you attack staff, that's solitary for like 6 hours. Serious injury, that's fine. Intoxication. You know, intoxication, I'm going to put that as lockdown. I don't think you need to go to solitary for intoxication. If you do any of this, I feel like you should be searched. So, if you escape, definitely search the cell and himself. We'll just search everybody. No matter what you do, if you do anything, your cell and yourself are getting searched. We find tools, you're going to solitary for like 4 hours. 4 hours and 4 hours. Everyone's going to solitary. We're going to get use out of all these solitary cells, all right? Everyone is going to get some solitary confinement. Oh my goodness, what is going on? Flipping heck, did we get any more gang members? No, there's still only 9 gang members. But flipping heck, why are all these people in here? There are no canteens accessible by the cell. Why? Why are you guys not being sent to minimum security? We have got a ton of space for minimum security guys. Is it because they can't get there? Do we have to like put down, we might have to put down doors. If we go to object and then I think just normal doors will be fine. Like we've got this weird jail door right here from when this used to be a cell. Let's dismantle that. And you know what? We'll use large jail doors. We'll do this here. We'll put, that's already there. This, do we want to make that a large jail door? I feel like we have to. We'll make it a normal door. We'll put doors there and there. I'm trying to make it so that this, like, area of hallway is considered its own room. Because if we can do that, that means that we can set this as, like, public area. And I'm hoping that will allow us to transfer all of these guys down to their minimum security cells. Although, we got this guy here just fine. But that could have been when we accidentally didn't have this set to normal security. So we'll see. We'll see. They're gonna take down this door. We're gonna replace it with a large jail door. It's gonna mean a lot more door opening for the guards. We should probably look at getting an automatic door opening system set up so that we don't have to have guards open up all these doors all the time. Also, we will end the shakedown. We'll end bang up as well because people are just gonna be annoyed otherwise. Everyone out into the yard. Are people complaining about hygiene? Not particularly. They are a little bit, but not too much. It's not like it's that big of a deal. Are we dismantling this? I would like rid of this, please. So we can get down a new large jail door. You know what? Forget it. We'll put it like right there. Found a screwdriver. Flipping heck. Also, I feel like we should put like trash cans in the kitchen. Like we should be able to bin some of the stuff that we have here. So you know, we'll put down like some trash cans there and there. So if they need to throw stuff away, it doesn't just like end up on the floor. But there's our large jail door. So can we set this to... Okay, so we've like undone everything. All right. Here, here, and here is all... That's not fixed this bit here. This is still like classified as one area, which is a little bit annoying. But all of our minimum security guys have gone somewhere. I'm not quite sure where. Oh, they're all here. They're all eating right now. Okay, that's fine. Oh, it's probably because we had bang up on. Everyone was probably just in the cell because we put them in the closest cell we could fit them in. That is probably why. And also, everyone this morning went for a parole hearing in a dark room because there are no lights whatsoever down here. You know what? If you're in solitary confinement, you don't get a light. The lights are going outside in the hallways like this and there. Actually, we'll do it like there. Just to be a bit more symmetrical. We'll put like one here and then here. And then we'll have one in each of these rooms as well. Like so. Nice. All right. Flippin' heck, that was quite the morning. Jeez. Let's get back over here real quick. Let's see about finishing up this grant. So we want electrical cable to run over and probably down like so. We want to make sure that we go to the clone tool and then let's... we don't have like a layout for this one, do we? We have to put it down ourselves. All right, object, bed, gonna go there. Toilet, gonna go there. Jail door, gonna go there. All right, cool. Cool. Let's throw down some small pipes going all the way along like so. All the way down there, all the way up here, and then we'll have like a large pipe that runs. I really don't like this. Can we replace that? I think we can. Yeah, let's do that, and then let's hook this up, and not with a hot water pipe, with a normal small pipe like that. And then once all that is done, we should be pretty much good to go. We do need to make sure that this down here is set up as a normal cell. That does not want to be a cell. That wants to be part of the shower. And then all we have to do is throw down a bed, not a bunk bed, just a standard bed, and a toilet. And a bed. And a toilet. Alright, cool. So, once all of that is done, we should be good to complete that second grant. So let's copy you. Let's paste it down a few times over here. They are all set to cells. We could have got a prison capacity of 89. So we are almost there. We do also need to clone that for here, 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 and here. And then once that's done, we should then have a prisoner capacity of 80 tomorrow. We got 14 new minimum security guys coming. It's slowly ticking up. It's not gone as high as I would like, but I guess kind of slowly giving us the prisoners is probably a better way to do it. Like, if we'd have just received 50 more minimum security guys as soon as we built this wing, that would have probably resulted in a lot more incidents. So it's probably a good thing that we were given them, like, slowly over the course of a few days. But there we go. That shower is now fixed. All the minimum... Oh, whoa. What is this? What is... I don't like that. Search cell. Search everybody. I want everybody here getting searched. We can also, like, most of the tunnels that are dug through the toilets. And so, one way we can find... Oh my goodness, these guys had flipping... Scissors on them? How did they get into soldier confinement with scissors? Like, how does that even happen? Anyway, we can get rid of toilets. Like, we can break these toilets to try and find tunnels. But that takes a lot of time and effort to go and dig up all the toilets and put them all back down. So I won't do that just yet. And also, they do have to go quite far out to actually escape. They've got to dig quite a distance. So hopefully, we will find them during the shakedowns and stuff. But we'll see. We will see. All of our maximum security guys have got put in a holding cell because they're no longer allowed in the minimum or normal security areas. And also, I was talking about this earlier, the materials. So, some materials are faster than others. For example, the dirt that's outside here has a slower movement speed than, for example, paving stones. And so, if we were to replace, like, this with some paving stones and maybe run it, you know, around and between some of our areas, this will make it a lot... All of our workers will become a lot faster at getting from place to place. It was a bit expensive. We just spent over $1,000 on paving stones there. But once we get those down, they'll be able to run round outside here a little bit faster. And eventually, we'll probably have like paving stones going around the prison. You can also do the same inside, although I think the default ones here are pretty fast, but I could be wrong. I know the concrete tiles are walking speed fast, but again, I'm pretty sure that the default floor in your prison is also fast, so I don't think that's something that we have to worry about. The canteen seems to be holding up just fine with the amount of people, although one thing that I did want to do is change the regime, because I don't really want minimum and normal security guys working or eating at the same time. And so we're gonna have the minimum security guys are gonna eat at 7 and 8, and then they're gonna shower after they eat. The normal security guys are gonna eat at 9 and 10, and they're gonna just have like an extra hour of sleep and then a shower. It doesn't matter if they have showers at the same time or if they have showers at similar times. So now they shouldn't be at the canteen at the same time. They should never be at the canteen at the same time. We'll bump this up as well. We'll make that yard time. This is yard time. Do I want to push this back? I don't want them to eat too close together. But you know what? We can probably get away with 2 meals a day. So we'll give them some free time there. And then we'll go lockup, work/lockup. So we have a long time in lockup. And then they're going to eat again. Whereas the normal security guys are going to work a little earlier. And they're also going to eat a little earlier. So they can eat there. And then they can go to lockup afterwards like that. Yeah, okay, so now no one's... These two shouldn't be eating at the same time anymore. Which, Hopefully it's going to be a good thing. We'll also change this to work/lockup. We'll leave that as free. Actually, no, we'll give them free time here at the end of the day. So they're free time before they go to sleep. We'll make this work/lockup because hopefully we're going to have everybody working. Like I said, I might change this to be another cleaning cupboard so we can get more people working in the cleaning sector so we don't have to have as many janitors. So you know what? Let's do that, actually. Let's go down here. Let's find the cleaning cupboard. Let's stick this down over here, and that should give us a bunch more jobs. Again, we'll put, like, a large jail door on there. And last episode, I went to go deploy an armed guy inside of the cleaning cupboard, I think. But didn't I've actually put them inside of this little office here, which doesn't do anything. So let me put an armed guard in here, like that. And then, do I want to put an armed guard down here? I don't really, because it seems like a bit of a waste. But at the same time, the amount of stuff that he smuggled out of the out of the cleaning cupboard here is a little ridiculous. Let's have a look at intelligence. And we've got confidential informants. This guy is our confidential informant right now. He's got 18% coverage, which has definitely gone up since last episode. I think he's the one who's telling us who all of the gang members are. He doesn't really have any kind of read on the minimum security guys, which is not really surprising. He doesn't spend any time with them. Also, why is our prisoner capacity only at 90? Is it because, are these not classified as cells? Oh, they're not. Okay, so that is, and then this one. Get rid of that. There we go. Grant complete. Whew. We've now got a prisoner capacity of 100, which is not going to fill up too quickly because they are kind of going to trickle in over time. And also, I kind of want them to not share the same yard. Like right now, minimum and maximum, or minimum and normal, all go and share the same yard, which I don't really want to be a thing because I want them to spend as little time as is possible in the same area. Also, let me get rid of like all of the planning. Like I don't need any of this stuff just yet. We can put that back down later, but I kind of feel like they should have their own yard. And I'm thinking I might put it like right here. Like if we have like a yard there, and then we have the building with the parole and stuff, like, over here. That could be a little bit better. Although, that does seem like a small yard. Maybe the other way around. Maybe we'll have, like, this be parole. Let's have a look. One, let's see, five is there. So, it needs to be 5 by 5. So, that's one parole room, if we get rid of that. And then 5, like this, and like that. That's going to be another parole room. And if, for example, you know what? We can have this go... We can have this pretty far up. Like, if we get rid of a lot of this and instead do something like this. We have, like, a pathway here. And then we just have another wall. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then back wall like that. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wall. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wall. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then wall. I think that would probably be a better idea. So you know what? We'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of that. We'll get rid of this. I was going to have it come round like this. I was going to have it be like that, but that seems like a... I like the idea of having a weird shape, but this just seems entirely pointless as part of the yard. So we'll get rid of that. That's going to be our yard. This is going to be our parole building with a pathway that goes along like that, and we can connect it up here as well. So we can have like walls there and there. We can have a wall there and there. And that's going to be obviously a path that comes through into here. That's not right. That wants to be there. So the pathway is going to come round and through into here like that. And that gives us a much larger space for the yard. That does... We've got these paroles down here, which I think we might change at some point because I don't think we need 3 parole rooms dedicated to medium security, especially if we're going to have 2 parole rooms a day. So we can probably change that at some point. But this looks good over here, and then we'll have this be the yard. So let's grab some fence real quick, and let's go ahead and lay this out. I guess it can just be, like, from there if we do, like, this and this and that. And then we can just go ahead and bulldoze the walls, like if we just get rid of this and this. But I'm gonna cancel those for now because I want to make sure that fence is up before we bulldoze those walls. Oh my goodness, look at this. This guy's a minimum security guy with his scissors. He got out with the scissors. Thankfully he's a fool. He can't actually escape, can he? What the heck? How did he get through that door? Why is this door open? Closed. Oh my goodness, I should have locked that shut. But I'm gonna say it, we've got him. What the? You know what? Maximum security. What a guy. And now he's complaining that he needs a pee. What a guy. Where did he come from? Is he right here? Flipping, you know what? We're searching the cell block. Where did this guy come from? Flipping heck. And also, why is there a maximum security guy in minimum security? Why is that about? Heck, shakedown. The whole prison. We're going to search the whole prison. Oh, my goodness. I'm glad we built this fence wall now. And also, I feel like we need to push this fence wall back because... Actually, I don't know. I think the fence wall's probably fine. If they've got a tunnel out, they've still got to go quite a way here. My goodness. All this time, we've had these minimum... Oh, my goodness. Where were you going to go? Maximum security. Flipping heck. I mean, to be fair, maximum security doesn't mean a whole lot nowadays. It means you go to the holding cell. So we definitely need to change that. Also, why is this still here? I'm fairly certain I dismantled that multiple times over. I still don't know where this guy came from. Where did this guy come from? Also, let's demolish these walls and these walls so these guys can actually get outside. But where did he come from? Have we searched these cells? Like, where was he? Or was he like... I'm sure he just escaped from minimum security, so he has to have been in here. Search this cell block again. I am not confident that you have managed to find this tunnel. I don't know where it came from. I think if we have a member of staff dig up the tunnel, we might, or try and remove it, we might find out where it came from as well. But I want to know exactly where that came from, because that is not acceptable. Not even a little bit. Flipping heck. Aye. Did we find anything? It looks like we have not found anything. Let's get rid of this. We don't need that. Let's set this up as a big old yard. There we go. We will go back into deployment here. We'll make this medium security only, and we'll make this minimum security only. That does mean we're going to have to put in a bunch of stuff. So, you know, we'll put down some benches. We'll give them somewhere to sit down if they want to sit down. I'm going to move that up a little bit to there. We'll put down... do we want to have another toilet area? We probably do, but we'll put down some phone booths first. We'll put those down just, like, in a big old line along the back wall here. Get that family need taken care of. Oh, my goodness. He actually went quite far. Wow, I'm somewhat impressed. I assumed it'd be this guy who had just like gone out and down, but he actually made it pretty far in a really small amount of time as well, I might add. Gosh, dang it. You know what? As well, just to make this as safe as possible, this fence is going to go to there, and then this fence is eventually going to go up to this wall as well. Flipping, so in case someone does try and dig out here, they've got to go just a little bit further. They can't just get out there and run. He could have got out here. Like, he didn't need to go this far down. He could have stopped there. And if he was going to go this far, you might as well have gone past the fence. Flipping heck. All right, did we put down any weights benches? I don't think we did. So let's grab some of those. Let's put those down, like, along out here. Like so. There we go. And then let's build our little kind of, like, outside... toilet area, which is gonna go like, do I want it to go like right there? You know what? We're not gonna make it. We're just gonna do what we did before. We're gonna have like just little rooms with toilets on like this. We don't have one there because that's gonna go and I don't want to have it like that. I want it to go there, there, and there. All right, and we're just gonna put standard doors on the front like this. It's a little more elegant than the one over in medium security, but it's fine. And we're already running pipes there. We'll run pipes there. That should be fine. That should be fine. And you know what? Just for minimum security, we'll throw down some grass as well. It's going to be a bit expensive. It was $1,000. We got $34,000, though. So, you know what? Boom. And you know what? Actually, you know, we'll do the same thing up here. We'll do the same thing for these guys. We might as well. I'm not going to put it in the toilets because that seems a little excessive. but we'll put it on. We'll put it all around like that. Jeez, it has been... It's been crazy. It has been crazy. We've had an escape attempt. These guys get grassy toilets, so I guess that's a thing. Wow. I'm surprised. Oh, there's a guy here as well. Oh, he was trying to get to the same place. Oh, my goodness. I didn't even see this one. Remove that. And then did we get rid of this one? No. Remove that. Why is... What is going on? Why is there a maximum security guy here? You know what? We need to plan out the maximum security area. So, I'm thinking... It's going to be like a big old building up here. And we're obviously going to not have like that there. We're going to have pathways that come in. And then much like with the rest of them, we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. Now that makes a cell. So let's just do this and this and this and this. It probably doesn't need to be quite so big just yet because the amount of maximum security prisoners we have is not very high. And I also don't intend to take in any maximum security prisoners, at least not anytime soon. 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, I think we might just leave it like that. And so our maximum security wing is going to end up looking an awful lot more like just solitary. But if we just have, like, some people up here, we'll have, like, an armed guard walk up and down. And it's just a place that we can put our maximum security guys that is further away from everybody else. Do I want to move that up by one? No, not really. I'm thinking I don't want it to touch this building because that kind of messes with the aesthetic that we've gone for, where we've got, like, these walls, all these spaces between our buildings. But if I do that, it's going to mess with the spacing that we've got. But you know what? I'm going to do it anyway. Let me get rid of this. Let's bump it up by one. So it's going to go there. And I'm just going to become one less. And then we're going to have like a corridor that goes up to there. Pathway that goes along here. We'll probably expand it out this way like we had before later on down the line if we figure out that we don't have enough space for all of our maximum security prisoners. But for now, this will be fine. It's going to be a really small maximum security wing. But it's going to get them out of the way of everybody else. It's going to make sure they're not in this holding cell. They're not in with all this. We'll give them their own eating time. We might even give them like their own little yard, like just attached onto the end of this or something. Also, we seem to have missed grass. Can we like fill this in? There we go. What's down? Oh, this one looks beautiful. Look at that. Look at that. Do I want to put like gravel or like a concrete floor or like something inside of these toilets so it doesn't look as absolutely horrible as it does right now? You know what? Ceramic floor. That's kind of the thing. Does that have to be inside? Oh, it does. Okay, so that can't go outside. Maybe just road? Sure. You know what? You're going to the toilet, you're going to stand on some road. Also, where is our wall? There needs to be a wall here dividing these people. Flipping geez. Also, we need to work on radiators because right now, is it in here or is it in? Yeah, it's right there. Right now, if we go back to temperature, our prison, I wish you could keep temperature up whilst you were putting radiators down. Right now, our prison is pretty warm in this, like, middle area here. Probably, like, around this water heater. But is, like, really cold when you get further out. So, you know what? Let's grab a radiator. We'll put, like, one there. We'll put one, like, there. And then we'll have one there and there. All right. And we'll put, like, one here. And we'll also give one to the staff block as well. The chief. Actually, you know what? No, the warden. You can have a radiator that's going to warm that entire building. And we do have to hook these up with hot water pipes. Thankfully, we do have hot water coming through from this hot water heater. I'm not quite sure how far that can go, but I guess we're about to find out when we put that in. Also, let's run you along to there, and actually all the way just along to there. And I guess we're going to try and run this up and into the warden's office and see if that works. Hopefully it will. We'll see if that actually works at all. If it does, that should take care of pretty much all of our heat issues. Do we have anybody who would like to be a confidential informant? It doesn't seem like there are. You only find them if they're in solitary. This guy does not feel like being a confidential informant whatsoever. Is this all of the stuff that's... Oh, these are all the stuff that's in this, like, office block. Oh, I see. Okay. Oh, what's going on? Who's fighting? This guy's injured. What did he do? He wants freedom? He attacked staff. He's got 6 hours in solitary. What a guy. This guy wants, like, alcohol? Sure. I mean, you're in prison, so no. But, I mean, it's fair enough. Let's get some walls in over here. Concrete walls. Boom. 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 And boom. Nice. All right. We need lights in there as well. Make sure everyone can see that what they're doing in maximum security. Don't want there. Want them to be there. There we go. We'll definitely have a guard patrolling there. We probably need to hire a new armed guard because we almost certainly don't have enough for what we've got. We've got 1, 2, 3 armed guards set up. I think we only have 3 armed guards in total. If we go to staff, no, we've only got 2. Okay, so let's go back to objects. Let's go to the armory and then let's see about throwing down a couple more of the guard lockers here. So we'll go boom, 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 boom. I can't put one there because the CCTV camera's there. That's fine. I want to have a few extra just lying around because they do get tired and then they have to go and sit down and they take breaks. So we want to make sure that people are always constantly on the rotation. Also, why did these pipes never get connected? What? What's up with that? But apparently the radiators worked. How are we doing now for temperature? It's actually a lot warmer. That is a lot better. The warden's office, for some reason, that's not passing through to the rest of this building. Probably because there were no hallways around here. These, like, radiators were placed inside of hallways. Whereas, I guess if we put them in cells, that wouldn't have happened. And also, oh, what's happened? What's happened? Substance of the land has destroyed a section of your outer wall. It should be repaired immediately. Alright, that's fine. That's fine. That's not too big of a deal. Here we go. Boom. Watch now, there'll be like a tunnel here and just thousands of prisoners will run out. We don't even have thousands, but they'll escape anyway. Oh my goodness. Please tell me those walls are still getting built. Yeah, they are. Okay. They're just taking the time. They got other stuff to do. Oh, also this laundry room that we set up is just entirely hasn't been working throughout the entirety of today's episode. And that's probably drove a few people absolutely insane. Let's go and hook that up. Oh my goodness, our minimum security area is looking a lot better now. Let's edit our guard patrol so that he does occasionally go and check out what's going on over here. It is 11 p.m. We've got 100 prisoners, our space for 100 prisoners, and only 24 guards. I feel like we need more guards. Let's bump this up to 30. There we go. I don't want to have too many, because they do cost quite a bit, but I feel like this is, like, we had too few. Do we have... We've unlocked tasers. I think we have to have, like, a taser class. It says extends the taser program so that your regular guards may carry tasers for defense. They must take it to the arm. They must visit the armory to get this equipment, and it will cost you for every taser you purchase this way. Do we have to do some kind of... if we go to programs, is there some kind of, like, guard taser program? I don't... guard taser certification. Okay, start. No room found? Is this not done in the armory? Or does it have to be done in, like, a classroom? It might have to be done in a classroom, and we don't currently have a classroom. Is there a certain size that a classroom has to be? Yes, it has to be 5x5, which is really annoying, because I was hoping we could squeeze it in over here, even though this is a cleaning cupboard, and we should get some people in here. So you see, this one's a little bit bigger, and so a few more people can work in here than can work in this cleaning cupboard. Where do we want to put a classroom? Do I want to, like, tack it on to the back of the, like, the armory here? Like, we've got this armory, which is, I believe, 5 wide, so we could just go, like, we could do this and build that there, and that could be our classroom, but the classroom, it needs to be not just for the guards. The classroom is also going to be used later on down the line for the prisoners as well, and so I'm thinking more, like, over here. Also, oh, we need to get rid of this wall. I'm looking at this, like, why are they not building stuff? Get rid of that wall, then they can build stuff in there. I'm also thinking about expanding out over here, though. Like, if we get a big, old, new building over here. Like, even just going all the way up like that. You know what? Yeah, let's do this. And then we're going to have probably some more cells along the left side here. But then on the right side, we'll put some more stuff. So we'll put, like, down the classroom. We'll probably end up putting the workshop somewhere up here as well. We've also got, like, the mail room, the shop. There's all kinds of stuff that we can put up there. It does require an entrance. So you know what? This guy is about to be out of home. Because this is no longer a cell. You can no longer be in here. You know what? Because you were the guy, let me look at his rap sheet. He got 21 years for arson, although he did plead not guilty to all of these. You know what? Minimum security. Boom. Just because we've got space in minimum security for this guy. Objects, let's go ahead and dismantle all of these. Let's bulldoze this wall right here, and then here and here. Alright, cool. This is going to be our new block. We're going to put some more medium security guys in here, and we're also going to have our new utilities in there as well. This is all looking pretty good. Also, it's 4 a.m. It's time for a shakedown. I do not want more people tunneling out. Our prison's getting pretty big pretty quickly. Wow, I didn't expect it to get so big so quick. How do these guys have stuff? They're in the holding cell with a guard. What is that? Hopefully, if there are any tunnels, we will find them. Because I'm very worried right now that there are going to be more tunnels that we just do not find. And also, we need hot water down at this radiator, so we'll get that going as well. We're probably using, like, all of our workmen. We could hire some more. We could bump this back up to 15. You know what? That's exactly what I'm going to do. I completely didn't notice, but we do have these paving stones down that look pretty nice. We've got 6 people awaiting solitary confinement. I'm going to guess that those guys, yeah, those guys are minimum security, because right now we do not have a solitary confinement area for people in minimum security. They just kind of have these cells. This is max. This is medium only, and I don't think we can change that just yet. If we go to deployment, no, we can't. What if we put a large jail door there and there? Because I would like to make this solitary confinement shared, because I kind of want to make the minimum security guys walk through normal security to get to solitary, just kind of scare them a little bit. Let's see here. Deployment, yes. This is going to be everybody. And so now all of our solitary guys should get taken down to here, whether or not they're minimum or medium. And then this is almost done. Let's just run some electrical cable up like that. And then let's go ahead and we'll just copy and paste the cells that we have down here. They're just going to be the exact same cells that minimum security have. We don't need that back wall. Just needs to look like that. And then up here, this is going to be where all of the maximum security guys spend their days and their nights. And for the time being, we will have maximum and minimum, maximum and normal security doing kind of the same thing. I think that's how the report is set up right now. So maximum and normal security are kind of doing the same thing. Eventually, again, I do want to change that because right now our gang members are in maximum security, or our gang leaders. Why is everybody annoyed? Why is everybody annoyed? They need hygiene? Do they not? They not shower in the morning? They have a shower at 8 a.m. What time is it? It's 8 a.m. Why? Why is there an issue? There shouldn't be an issue. The need for hygiene is going down, but the danger is going up. People have serious complaints. And also, somebody has already been in a fight, which is not good. We could search him, which I guess is the one way to go. This guy wants food. He's going to get food pretty soon. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, it looks like the maximum security guys are the ones causing the issues. So why are you here? No, whoa, 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 whoa. Why? Whoa. This is not how this is meant to be. No. This is medium security only. Minimum security guys, you've got your own shower. It's right here. Oh, my goodness. Look at this. They're all being sent out. They're all mixing and... Oh, this is not good. A guard is dead. What? Who killed the guard? This guy is deadly. Maximum security. Flippin' egg. And you know what? Show up sheet. You're going to get like 20, 48, a million hours in solitary confinement. Flippin'. We got a guard died. Jeez. Oh my goodness. The prison. Oh. Everyone back to yourselves. Get back to yourselves. Oh my goodness. Also, we didn't even put flipping drains down here. Jeez. All right, there we go. Okay. Everyone get back to your cells. We're having a day inside. Oh my goodness. What is this? Everybody is so annoyed. They want family. We might need to get a bigger visitation room, especially right now. I'm pretty sure that minimum security can't get to the visitation room, although they might be able to walk through. I'm not too sure. Flipping heck. All right, I will release the bang up just because people need to get stuff. Otherwise, they're just going to get more angry. But with that, guys, I'm going to end this episode of Prison Architect there. Next time, we'll come back and we'll try and fix all these issues we're having. We'll try and get the anger levels and the danger levels in the prison down. We'll try and meet the prisoners' needs and stop people rioting and attacking and doing all that kind of stuff. We will set this up here as a maximum security zone. We've got to put a door on it to make that happen. So let's put that there. Let's quickly run some pipes up through here as well to make sure all these guys can actually use their toilets. The electrical cable is almost run up. We just need one guy to run out there and connect that up. But like I said, with that, guys, we are going to end this episode of Prison Architect there. As always, if you did enjoy the video, be sure to hit like. It really does help out a lot. Leave a comment down below, and I will see you guys next time.